Select the verbal scenario that matches the graph. So let's take a look at this graph here. Maybe we can figure out some information that'll help us narrow it down. The graph is going downhill from left to right, which means it has a decreasing pattern to it, and that means it has a negative rate of change. And that should make sense. I mean, if a graph is going uphill from left to right, you have increasing as a positive rate of change. It's the amount of change per unit. So here we're going down for each unit over, and let's see if we can identify. It looks like it's going 2 down and 1 over each time. So down 2 over 1, negative 2. That means negative 2 is that rate of change. The other piece of information that defines a linear function is the initial value. And you get that from the vertical, or usually the y-axis. So right up here, it's at 20. So the initial is 20. So we have the rate of change is negative 2, the initial value is 20. Let's take a look and see what we can do now. An online movie rental service charges $20 to start and $2 per movie. Okay, well, this is a possibility because you have $20 to start and the rate of change is 2. Now, I'm a little hesitant because I don't know if it's 2 or negative 2. So let's keep reading and compare with some other choices. Your mobile phone plan gives you 200 minutes and you use 10 minutes per day. Well, the initial value here is 200, not 20, so this is definitely out. You've eaten 2 Big Macs and will eat 20 Big Macs per month. Wow, that's a lot of Big Macs. The initial value here is 2. We're looking for an initial of 20, so this one's out. And actually, the 20 is the rate, so the 2 and the 20 are actually reversed here. You owe your friend $20 and pay him back $2 per day. So your initial value is 20, $2 per day. So what if this graph represented the amount of money that you owed your friend? You're starting at $20, and then every day, $2 is the amount you're paying back. That actually fits perfectly. Let's compare with this online movie rental service. $20 to start and $2 per movie is the charge. So really what that means is it's adding $2 each time. So you start at 20, then up to. That would be the amount you're paying this way. This is a positive rate of change. And this D, we're representing paying back $2. You're taking $2 away from the amount you owe him, so it's a negative rate of change. So that's why D is the best choice here.